looking at calibration of DRO, and that is just because you fitted some DRO scales and a readout to your machine, it doesn't mean to say that the reading you're getting is correct. There could be a deviation in that reading, and to check that, you need to check it against a standard. Now, by a standard, I mean you may have some slip gauges or block gauges, and you can use the block gauges as a standard to check against your DRO. Let's say you've got a set of imperial block gauges. You could build up with those gauges a 10-inch length to check your DRO. So you build up your 10-inch length of block gauges and use the calibration chart that came with the gauges to determine the actual length of those blocks, because each block may be a small amount undersized. If you add it all together, it will tell you the actual length that you've got. So it might be half a thou less than 10 inches. Next thing you need to do, set the blocks up on the machine and then take a reading from one end of the block to the other end of the block and compare what your digital scale says the reading is. Now, if it's correct and it's exactly the same, then you don't need to alter anything. But if it's over or under, you may need to alter and calculate a compensation factor that will put the scale reading correct. So that's what we're doing in today's video. So let's go to the workshop and see how we do it. Today, I'm just checking my digital readouts to see that the display value is the same as the actual movement value. And to do that, you need to set a reference piece to the table. So what I have here, a couple of parallel strips in the slot. That's so I can put the gauge block in, push it up against the parallel strips, and I know it's parallel to the table. On this end, I have a small gauge block just to give me the height for this one, so I can touch a dial indicator on the front face, move back to this face, and get the length on the digital readout. So this block underneath is lightly clamped. Then I've pushed this block up against it, which is a 4-inch gauge block, and I've just lightly clamped it so this is not moving backwards and forwards or sliding. So now I've got my reference piece set up, and then later I can add extra blocks to this to see what the readout over a distance is. On the milling head, I've put a lever type indicator to give me a reference. Now, there's some things I'm not happy with. The lever indicator only goes to 0.01 of a millimeter. Then you will also have error on your gauge blocks, because most gauge blocks are slightly under the size that they say, but you need to refer to your calibration chart for your gauge blocks to see the more you build up how much deviation it is from a standard size. The other thing as well is temperature. Today it's fairly cold in the workshop, so I've fitted these blocks to the table. I've left them on the table for a good hour so they can adjust and become the same temperature as the table. So I'm trying to normalise the temperatures as best as I can. Now, if you're holding a gauge block in your hand for 10 minutes, it'll warm up, so the reading you get will have an error compared to these gauge blocks that are on a cold table. Another thing I should point out is if your linear scales are in metric, I would try and use metric as the measuring standard. If they're imperial, I would use imperial, because you don't want your display calculating something and putting more error into the reading. Although this gauge block is in imperial, I'm doing all my measurements in metric. This is just an aluminium clamping piece, and all it's doing is holding down the gauge block that's underneath lightly, and then stopping this gauge block on the top here from moving backwards. So when I've pushed this 4-inch gauge block up against that, it's level with the face. So what I'm doing now is moving the dial indicator forward while moving the table until I can get a zero reading the dial indicator. Looks about zero. Now I'll zero my x-axis scale. So this is in absolute zero and it's metric. And on my z-axis, I'll zero my z-axis to give me the position of the dial indicator. And the next thing to do is move the table to the end and lower the dial indicator down. And bring it back to zero. And then we'll take a look at the readout for that. There's the reading, 101.605. Now a 4-inch gauge block is 101.6, so I'm 0.005 longer. Now that could be the dial indicator, I don't know, or it could be the scale. So what I'll do next is add another gauge block to the table and we'll take it to the next length. I've just pushed a 3-inch gauge block on there. I've just zeroed the dial indicator at the start of the gauge blocks. Zero my X. Then go back to the other end of the blocks. I think that's right. The result is 228.945 and it should actually read 228.6. This is the correction coefficient formula for working out the error and the figure that you must enter into your display to correct the error. This applies to this digital readout but should be in your manual. So after you've worked out the calculation, you press X millimeters. It says that's it, compensation. So you enter the number in 1.50918. Enter. Now that should have put the scale correct. Let's see if the compensation makes any difference. Come back onto the dial indicator. And the reading for the length of the gauge box is 228.600 and 9-inch length of should be 228.600. So I've reset that to give the correct reading over 9 inches. Now we'll move on to the z-axis. I've changed to my plunger dial indicator, which is in tenths of a thou, so it's easier to see. I'll just lower this down so I zero it. Call that zero. Zero my z-axis on the scale. Then lower this down till I get zero. Now the reading I've got there is 101.570. And 4 inch should be 101.6. So it's just under. So this is the formula to calculate the correction factor you need. S equals L minus L, 1 divided by L divided by 100. Where L is the length in millimetres, and then this is the displayed length. So you've got the length that you're measuring and the actual displayed length that we did. Come down, this is the calculation that we did. So we've got a 4 inch gauge block, which is 101.6. So we've got 101.6, which is the length that was measuring, and it gave us 101.57. So that works out 101.6.03. Then we have on this side 101.6 divided by 1000. So then we've got 0.03 divided by 0.1016, and it comes out at 0.2952755. Now we need to put that into the z-axis as the correction coefficient. So we're looking at the z-axis. So what you need to do is 0z, and then z millimetres. Okay, and once you get compensation of z, we put the figure in here from the calculation, which was 0.29527. Enter. So we've got Z at zero. So if we remeasure the gauge block, hopefully it should come to the right size. So I'll remove the block and go down to the table. Come round to zero. It's about there. .101600, smack on. It's a bit fiddly. I don't know why sometimes it works and sometimes it doesn't, but as you can see, that's altered. The 4 inch reading before was 101.57. Now it's changed it to 101.6, which is dead on 4 inches. So that's two axes converted. So all I need to do now is look at my y-axis. Okay, the setup for the y-axis. Once more, I'm just holding this gauge block lightly. Move this square across. Now I can push the gauge block to get it square to the table. Just put a bit of load onto the back of that to stop this moving. We just move that round to zero, which is there. Now I'll zero my y-axis, that's zero. Lift up, move across, just lower it down so that the tip of the indicator is just above the slip gauge. Move it along till it zeroes. There. That's saying 101.610. So that's 10 microns out. And what I'll do, just to double check, I'll zero that there and do it backwards. 101.61. So we want to enter the correction figure. We're only 0.01 out on the reading, so I'll see whether I can get that to zero. So to do that, again, we zero Y, enter the value and put metric. It should come up with compensation of Y, which it has, and the reading was 0.0,
I've tried a few times and that's the best I can get the y-axis to. It should be 101.6, but it's 101.605, which is actually one division of the scale.
Oh well, that's it for today. Hope that's useful. I'll put the chart up again with the calculations on. Hope you found that interesting, and we'll see you next time on Enots Engineering.